Hello, everyone. Welcome. I am Lindsay LaChance. I'm the Artistic Associate of Indigenous Theater here at the National Arts Center. I'm from an Algonquin Anishinaabeg family and am here speaking with everyone from Algonquin Anishinaabeg Aki. I'm so happy that everyone's here today, and it's a great honor to introduce to you our amazing guest, Christy Belcourt. Hi, Christy. Thank you so much for coming and chatting with me today.
Hi. Thanks for having me.
So I was wondering if we could start just by having you introduce yourself and talk a little bit about how you identify and where your family's from.
My name is Christy Belcourt. I am Michif from Lac St. Anne in Alberta. I was raised in Ontario. My mom is from Nova Scotia. My dad's from Lac St. Anne. And I was raised in Ottawa for most of my life. And I have lived along the North Shore in Anishinaabeg territory for the last 20 years. I have two daughters. Both are Anishinaabe, and one is Anishinaabe and Métis. And I am currently in a town called Elliott Lake, Ontario, not far from our language camp, which is on the land. It's an Ojibwe language camp, and it's been sort of our a community project that we've been working on collectively as a collective group for about 3-4 years now. So we're still plugging away at it. that's what I'm doing up here.
Even from the images that we have shown up on the lantern, you can really see an attempt, a really visible connection, like you're saying, a reciprocity and acknowledgement of land, of women, of the water in the work that we're showing. And I think that's so important, especially to be shown on a mainstream platform, like a huge screen in Ottawa.
I really love the idea that people who are traveling by, maybe perhaps, would look up and see my artwork there, and for a brief moment find something in it that would be beautiful, that they could then see also the beauty within themselves and reflect on it, even if it's just for, you know, a second as they're driving by. But I really appreciate that, because it's so different than the gray and the brick and the black of some of the buildings. It brings a lot of beauty and light to the area. I've never been in Ottawa when it's actually been up, so I've only seen photographs of it. But the one that I really enjoyed seeing was when it had rained, and the reflection, you know, at nighttime of the colors of the artwork reflected in the puddles on the street was just really, it was really beautiful. And I often think, like, yes, I am very, you know, politically minded. I have very strong opinions, and that is oftentimes what motivates the art. But at the same time, my art itself is about plants and birds and about the land. And what I want is people to connect with that love that they have for their own favorite plants, their own favorite spots, their private spots on the earth that they love to go to, whether it's sitting by a river or sitting in a garden or going out into the forest. You know, that everybody has their own little spots that they love outdoors. And it's really important as human beings that we connect to those places, that we send our gratitude to the earth and to all the animals in the earth and the insects in the earth and the plants in the earth, because they sustain our life, and we're not able to live without them as human beings. We can't. They're the ones that keep the earth going.
I'm wondering if you wanted to speak a little bit more about why it's so important for you as an artist, as an activist, as a mother, as a family member, as so many things, to be able to use your artistic practice in the community work that you do.
As an Indigenous person, we often, I've noticed for myself at least, and some of my, I would say, other artist friends and colleagues, we've had discussions around the importance of responsibility and reciprocity to our own communities and to our own people. We're always keeping that in mind as we go forward in our practices, the responsibility of what we not only express from our cultural places or our nations, but also what we then are able to give back to our communities or our people, our nations, our broader nations. And I say nations with an S, obviously. I'm talking about Indigenous nationhood. I'm not in this reference speaking about the Canadian nation state. So it's important to me as an artist to always be thinking about how I am able to give back to people, and particularly at my age now, I'm really focused on what I can possibly do to give back to a younger generation who is looking to perhaps reconnect or reclaim the things that were taken away from their family lines or their communities through the project of colonialization.
I'm just wondering if you wanted to, if there's anything you wanted folks to think about or to remember June 21st, National Indigenous Peoples Day, or throughout the entire month of things to think about or ways that they can be active allies in the reality of ongoing Indigenous realities and struggles in the country.
As we go forward in the month of June, we're not only looking at the issues of our relationships between Native and non-Native people. This is really a time for us to celebrate who we are as Indigenous nations, and to, you know, just enjoy this month, and really not focus so much all the time on our relationships with non-Native people, but really to just appreciate each other and to appreciate Indigenous nationhood and Indigenous cultures, Indigenous languages, and to try and use our languages and to just focus on us as well, you know, focus on our own communities and our own selves, and really celebrate the strengths and the beauty that's within each of our communities and our nations and our cultures.
Miigwech. And Miigwech, so much for sharing that and for helping to open folks' minds, even during our conversation, about things that they can do or ways that they can really reconsider their positionality and privileges as Canadians. And, you know, we're so grateful for all of the work that you've done with your language camp, with the community art builds, and sharing your talent and your gifts with us to be able to highlight and to amplify your voice during this month. And so we're so grateful, and thank you for coming in and chatting with me today, and we look forward to seeing you again soon.
Oh yes, you're welcome.